So, welcome back. So, Trash Game Thursday or Thumbs Up Thursday? Well, I'm excited today because I think this is going to be a Thumbs Up Thursday day. Because Jack's brought something special into the studio. Woo! What you brought, Jack?
Riz.
Yeah,
exactly. Oh my god!
It's amazing! So yeah, you all know that Jack was waiting to get his Rift. Is it just a Rift? Is that what it's called?
Like a Riffmaster.
It's a Riffmaster. It's an RM.
the PDP Riffmaster.
And it's beautiful and shiny, and it's got lots of buttons on it. And we're going to see Jack have a quick go on it.
And you're going to play
Snoop Dogg. Yes, yeah, Snoop Dogg, because that's just been just come out on.
Hail to the King. That's actually a good one to start out with.
So yeah, so we're in Fortnite, as you will know, because you can see it there on the screen. But yeah, we've been looking forward to this for a while. So
I've run into a lot of people with good songs here.
Yeah, that's good.
That's a very interesting
thing. Snoop Dogg, drop it like it's hot.
Drop it like it's hot.
Balling.
Oh, I can't wait. They've all got new clothes on and all, haven't they? New clothes costumes. Oh, look, the audience are there. Oh, awesome.
And there's Snoop Dogg.
Oh, look at that. So you, I would imagine you have to pay for him, don't you, to get a snooper?
He's a thing that you have to... You can buy him from the shop.
You can buy him from the shop. I'm just going out of the shop to buy Snoop Dogg. Oh, look at that. Oh, it looks quite cool.
It does look good and proven to the festival. Like, you can see what he just bought. You can see how long the song is.
Yeah.
Now.
So they just put that one on up there, that weren't there before?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, Billie Eilish, we got pro mode. Metallica, we got battle stage. Karol G, we got pretty much nothing. And now with Snoop Dogg, we have a progress bar.
Yeah. You can also see, like, on some instruments, when you take a break as well, on there.
Yeah. This thing is pretty much a rock band guitar through and through, hence the more silent drum bar.
Jan Winger will shout Jan Winger out. He would like that, actually, because he hated the noise of the...
Hates how noisy the Guitar Hero guitars were.
He were always complaining. I don't know what to complain about now. I wonder if James will get one of these. You can get this for PlayStation, can't you?
Yeah,
they brought one out. Yeah, they brought out a PlayStation variant too.
What they should have done is just made a universal guitar, because the PlayStation one does not work on Xbox or PC.
No.
Which is so daft. Just checking, so the TV's definitely not quiet,
is
it? Well, we don't want to be copyrighted,
and
we don't want to
be on
camera or
the
mics.
Yeah, totally on purpose.
Oh yeah, there's a glitch in this game, as you had noticed. Snoop Dogg find an invisible instrument.
Yeah.
Oh wow, look at that.
Yeah, I saw that make the rounds on Twitter for somewhat air guitar.
When did that make rounds? Do you think they were sort of that out straight to her?
I mean, I've heard of character models locking up, but that is impressive.
It all seems to affect, like, the guitar and bass.
Yeah.
Don't really affect vocals or drums.
Jamie's just coming to see Snoop Dogg. Jamie plays Snoop Dogg on Call of Duty, don't you?
Yeah.
Snoop Doggy Dogg, Snoop Doggy Dogg.
Snoop Dogg's on everything, isn't it?
What will he be?
Massive brand. There you go, there he is. Yeah. He'll have his own anime,
won't he? Snoop Dogg, the Genshin Impact.
And then there'll be like a life story done on him, like a true story of movie. The life of Snooper, or Snoop Dogg. I bet you don't like getting called Snooper. But yeah. I mean, he even features in Devil Wears Prada. He doesn't feature in it, but he actually...
He
She refers to him, yeah. I put Snoop Dogg next to me. She says, I put him on my table. So. And Lewis is in room as well. Yeah. They're always criticising me, guys. My life's hard work. My place is the boss, Dan. And deal with it. So then, Jack, what are you thinking to that then? You like it?
Yeah, I got mine like, what, two months back? I'm pretty much loving this thing.
Yeah. So I need to watch you doing the thing.
How do you know to use bottom bit?
Well, it's more just there if you want to use it. Like it's more useful for like solos in Rock Band 4.
That's cool, isn't it? Anyway, I'm really pleased that we brought a new guitar out.
Because,
you know, it's been a long time.
So. Yeah, all harmonics had to do was get bought out by Epic. Yeah. Biggest gamble of their lives.
Well, you know, I hope that this game mode festival lasts for a long time then. Because recently that Rocket Racing kind of got nuked, if you will. They stopped.
Rocket League.
Yeah, like they got like a mode called Rocket Racing where you're just racing around in rocket cars.
Yeah.
They recently stopped updating that now because there weren't much interest in it.
Oh, wow. Well, hopefully they'll spend some more time on this then. Work glitches out and stuff in this.
Yeah. I'm just yeah, I'm just really hoping that festival is here to stay because this kind of fills that void for us.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I think we've been waiting for a rhythm game for a long time.
Yeah. And I don't know what it was like. I didn't play much of Rock Band 4 when it was a thing, but
it's watching Snoop Dogg.
He's
invisible at instruments. Yeah. Somebody didn't put some ink code in there, didn't they?
So if you want to ask away about this thing, feel free to, because this song is pretty boring to play on lead.
So yeah, so it's a six-stringed instrument, but it's got no strings. But it's got five buttons. As you can see, it's green, red, yellow, blue and orange, which is the same as the original guitar. But then it's got its nice little extra bit down bottom, which you only got on, were it the Beatles guitar? On.
Yeah, I think the Beatles Rock Band had guitar controllers, right?
Yeah, and it had the bottom bit, didn't it, on there? You've got your whammy on there as well, haven't you? So.
Well, it's pretty much useless in festival since it doesn't really give you extra star power.
Mm. And then that's the other thing you were telling us earlier on about star power, when you have to get your star power. Sounds a bit complicated. So what do you have to do, Jack, to get that?
Well, you can still tilt it upwards as normal, but in this game in Rock Band 4, to activate star power without having to do that, you now have to press left on the D-pad.
Which is a bit complex, because that is quite hard if you're in the middle of doing something. And what about,
I can't tell you how many times I've meant to press left, but accidentally pressed a diagonal doing that.
Yeah, and the dongle's in a secret place, guys. So you can dongle and go on. I would imagine you can dongle going on Clone Hero with your PC. Is that what the dongle's for?
I've only managed to get it working with a similar game called Yarg.
Ooh.
Sort of an acronym for yet another rhythm game. it's pretty much the Rock Band equivalent to Clone Hero.
Ah. So does this run on batteries then? Or?
Yeah, this pretty much has a lithium-ion battery inside of it. I've heard it has really good battery life. as well, like 36 hours, something like that.
Oh wow! So do you have to? You just charge it up then when you're done, and then hopefully it's charged up ready for next time. That's cool.
Yeah, although the fact that you can only use it wirelessly kind of concerns me about whether or not this thing can be used in the future. But yeah, you take off a pit guard.
Yeah.
And you have a spot to hide your dongle.
Yeah, your little dongle there. And also, I would imagine you can buy new plates.
Yeah, definitely people are going to be customising their face plates.
Yeah, definitely, which will be cool. It's really cool, it looks really good.
I've not used many Rock Band guitars in the past. I've always been more of an Explorer guy myself, but yeah, this feels very premium.
It does look very premium. I mean, the sort of like all other controllers, we've got a few cool ones, and there were a few really nice ones that come out originally with Guitar Hero and Rock Band and stuff like that, but the Explorer just seems to have edge because it's just the fact that it's just got a very long lead with a USB on the end of it, and it tends to be able to work.
Yeah.
In a lot of places, and I think that just gives it an edge, which is really cool.
Also, it has a nice little analog stick right on the back. Wonder what that could be used for.
Oh. Mm. Can you show me? It all folded up, doesn't it? As well, you can like fold the neck down, and then you can take the head gear off as well.
Yeah.
It's really, really cool. You can make it really small to put in your rucksack. Because Jack brought it in his rucksack, and I says, "Oh, have you brought it in?" And we're like, "Yeah." And I'm like, "Oh, okay then. Where is it?" And he got it, and it was all tiny.
That actually helps make the box a lot smaller too.
Yeah. So it's really cool. So yeah. Is a bit of a boring song, this one. What song is it?
But yeah, you just pull this part up.
Yep.
And the neck can fold just like that for easy storage.
Like a deck chair, guys. It's like a little deck chair.
And additionally, you can also take the headstock off as well.
That's cool. It just is really nice.
I mean it's still going to take a little bit of time to get used to since I'm more used to Guitar Hero guitars, the Explorers especially, but yeah.
Yeah, yeah. "8 Minutes" of Metallica.
This is my first time playing this chart, by the way.
Is it? Oh, nice one.
Making those little hammer-ons is certainly a choice.
It is very, very quiet though. It's when we have Explorer at, it's well noisy. But this one's really quiet. They still need to work out what they're doing with cameras and things, don't they, on this. They still just haven't quite got the good look about it that you got in so many Guitar Hero and Band Hero games. And I think Band Hero, it's called Band Hero, it's not Band Hero, it's Rock Band. But they just got it right, and they just need to work a little bit more on this epic, because that, you know, looking at it, that scene's okay. But then you've got these other scenes where it's just, because of where the camera angle is, you're not seeing enough of the stage, you're not seeing enough of what you want to see. And that's just blanking out the whole stage with the chart. So they really need to think about that and make it so it is nicer to look at. Because although, you know, when you're doing chart, you might not be looking too much at background. The fact is, why have a background then if you're not going to be looking at it at some point? So, yeah, there you go.
Yeah, there's our mini rants.
Yeah, but it is very, it's as if they filmed it very low down. They've got the camera angle at a low down angle, which is looking up slightly, and it's like ramping up with the actual chart, but it's not, it just doesn't feel right. So either decide that you're going to be audience and you're going to be looking up all the time, or decide that you're going to be giving us a nicer view, like you've got lots of cameras moving around doing different things. Like an overhead view would be nice, which I don't think I've seen yet. I mean, what's that? That's just nothing. I can't see anything there because there's some palm trees in background. You know, like that. What's going on here? Because he's rucksack. That's a big diamond. Although I do think his helmet's quite good, that blue weight big horns on his helmet. They look quite cool. You were on drums earlier on.
Yeah, did I really also good. Mention this whole stage got an overhaul in favour of Snoop Dogg?
Did it? It's all this Snoop Dogg style. I mean, to be fair, I don't really ever listen to any Snoop Dogg songs or anything. But I do like him as a person. I think he sounds, you know, he's quite cool.
Yeah, I think he's a pretty cool guy. Yeah,
we were talking in car earlier about, you know, other famous gamers that really would be cool to make an appearance in a game like this. And we were talking about Jack Black and Tenacious D and wondering why they aren't being pulled in for something like this, because that would be really cool. I know they fell out recently, but hopefully they'll...
Probably because they don't have that family-friendly image to them, you know?
Well, yeah, probably. Well, yeah, you're probably right there, Jack. That's maybe the reason why. Because Fortnite is probably more geared up to be family-friendly.
Yeah, it's more or less aimed at kids in a way.
Yeah.
I feel bad for all the people who chose vocals here.
Because there's hardly any.
Because this is like, what, 90 minutes of pretty much nothing from James?
Yeah. I guess the thing is, if you chose vocals, it's mainly because you've probably done all other instruments and you just want to have that on your pile of, I've done this. And your score and stuff.
Still, you don't know true pain on vocals until you've played Jailbreak from the AC/DC pack. Yeah, you literally have like a break where it's just like, what, 5 minutes of dead air?
Yeah. Yeah, you want songs where they're singing a bit. Otherwise, it should just be called as orchestral. Three minutes left.
Yeah, hope season 4 was a reminder to Gen Alpha, Metallica songs are too long.
Yeah. I mean, his scores are still really good. So obviously used to this guitar and used to gaming on here with it.
Yeah, to say I've only had it like two months now, I strangely feel right at home with it.
Yeah. Oh.
That's what made me feel tired.
I know, you look shattered when we come in, you were having a quick nap. Are you alright?
Yeah.
Yeah, Lewis is shattered. He's like, he did a load of recording earlier this morning, so he's, yeah. He was taking a nap earlier on. Yeah, he's not far off now, so. That's
not
good.
Too bad.
But yeah. What do you think to the Riffmaster? Have you liked seeing it?
The what?
The Riffmaster, what Jack's playing on the game, you know, his actual controller.
It's amazing. It's completely different to what I've seen in any Guitar Hero controller.
Yeah, it's cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
I just really wish they'd bring another Guitar Hero, you know, back, or a
like,
Rock Band.
I know this is essentially Rock Band 5 in spirit, but yeah.
It's just not the same, is it? I just like my discs. I'm going to put it on a disc. That's what we want to see. I like things on a disc in a box with a little booklet.
I mean, there's always like second-hand copies of Rock Band 4 to pick up if you need something else. To play this thing, to use this thing with.
And we got Rock Band 4. Is that the only one we've not got?
I don't know.
I can tell you, I've certainly no lived my copy of it when I got this thing.
We will get it. But we need to buy it. But yeah, Rock Band 4, guys. That's what you need, invest. Oh, I like that leg. That's cool, little glittery.
That being said, I don't know if it's something I'd want to experience here, though. I heard it runs like garbage on the original Xbox One.
Yeah. Mustard featuring Roddy Ricch. Okay. Orish. Oh dear.
Yeah, funny how we go from Metallica to this.
I mean, Metallica are a good band.
Yeah, definitely.
Why else would you think they got their own Guitar Hero game?
Yeah.
There's a lot of bands that missed out on getting their own Guitar Hero game, and I just feel like I wish... That's one of the things that I do miss. Yeah, I mean... There's just so many bands out there that would have just been so cool to have had a full game dedicated to them on this format.
We could have gotten Pearl Jam Rock Band, and that's not me making it up.
No, that would have been cool.
I mean, they're a good rock band as well.
Yeah.
Primal Scream.
Yeah. Garbage. I love Garbage. Garbage are one of my favourite bands, so...
I think my dad's personal wish list for a Guitar Hero game would have been Guitar Hero Foo Fighters.
Yeah, I mean, Foo's, they're starring quite a lot at games, but I just think Foo's have got such a massive back catalogue now. Some great game, some great stuff. I think definitely.
And
Muse as well. Muse should have had their own as well.
I thought Alice Cooper.
Alice Cooper, yeah. With all his eyeliner on. I was watching this horror film. This is back in the day when you used to rent a video from video library shop, like Blockbusters. And we put this film on. Because you used to go and like get three films for a price or two or something for renting.
Yeah.
And your third one would just be right, a really tripey one that you may or may not watch. Anyway, we got these films and put this film on, and it was a horror film. And then who should walk out at Dark Shadows? But it was Alice Cooper. And he was actually in the film as a villain. He was like an evil devil type character.
Oh, yeah.
And he just looked the part. And we were laughing his heads off because it was like, you know, we didn't actually see him as an actor.
Wait, no, this is perfect.
But he were good. He were good in it. But the film were rubbish. It was a rubbish film. But he were really good in it. Yeah, it was just funny because every time he come on and he got all his eye makeup on and that, like, and he just... Yeah.
I know he was in Wayne's World.
Yeah, Wayne's World. Everybody's been in Wayne's World, haven't they? Just about.
Yeah.
Madonna, that would have been another really good Guitar Hero to do. She's got a massive back catalogue.
Oh, God.
And Michael Jackson.
I mean...
Some people wouldn't like that, but...
Yeah.
I quite like Michael Jackson. Makes me tap my feet when I listen to his music.
I mean, say what you want about the guy, but he made good music.
He did. He knew how to entertain.
100%. Lovely.
Well done, Jack.
I know someone's probably gonna say it for me, but Guitar Hero Dragon Force.
Yes.
Definitely. I know there is a song on Guitar Hero of it on.
I mean, the whole discography's pretty much been chartered at this point.
Mm.
Yeah.
Imagine if they put it into Fortnite.
I don't know why they don't, because it is good. And it is kid-friendly. There's no horrible in them, in their music. Dragon Force, I think most of the stuff they do is decent.
Maybe not so much when they're live, but yeah, their studio stuff, they're pretty clean for the most part.
Yeah. And they're fun. Nice, long, epic games.
I mean,
it probably wouldn't have the same impact since you can't really fail in this, but still. This song, I believe, was originally made for a free update for Rock Band 4.
Oh, yeah.
Basically from a made-up band called Scratch and Sniff.
That is a really weird name.
It is. Back in the day when you spy stickers and it was Scratch and Sniff, weren't it? Scratch the sticker and sniff it, and it was like, what? I ain't got a sense of smell, so it didn't really appeal to me.
Oh, nice.
That was clean.
Now
I've
fully woke up now.
Are you alright now?
Yeah.
Sections that get your adrenaline going.
I should have had my dilute.
Yeah, your drink. Do you need to have a drink, John? You can go and get it if you want.
Yeah, that is an old drink.
Yeah. Yeah, loose. Wake you up a little bit.
Yeah. Normally what I do when I do gameplay videos is stick to one game.
Yeah. Is that your character with rucksack on? This one. I'm doing all that now, Jack.
Yeah.
It's a cool costume, that, isn't it? Wow.
I don't really buy into microtransactions, so I just sort of deal with what I can get for free.
I must admit, I'm the same. I just deal with whatever gun somebody gives me, whatever's going on. I'm just like, yeah, I'll just
How
keep them.
How long have you been playing Fortnite then, Jack?
Well, I was into Battle Royale for a bit, then I got tired of it.
Yeah, I started in 2018 when
same here actually.
I believe it was the third season of the game, as I was a bit of a really bad player as I had no idea about building and all that. But it doesn't matter in the end.
No.
I've got a lot better since then.
I mean, I've not been on it very much. I've enjoyed it when I've been on it, though. I think it's quite a good game.
Yeah.
I think after when I looked at this and PUBG, because when PUBG come out at the same time, didn't it, roughly?
Yeah.
The difference is that this were free, which made it a lot better, more accessible.
I mean, Lego Fortnite is also free as well.
Is it? I've not played that, and I would like to play that, because I love Lego.
Oh, no, it is. It'll be still on the original Fortnite.
Yeah, that's cool.
So there's no need to download it or anything.
That's really cool.
What the hell was that?
Censorship at its best, my friends. Mother, what?
We do not allow swearing.
Sorry, sir, this is a Christian server, so no swearing.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
If that was my brother and he heard that, he'll be like, why am I here?
What is this?
Don't tell me it says the N-word.
Nah, it's just blanked. Yeah. That's probably for the best.
Okay, I was gonna say.
There's only so much you can do with a PEGI 12 rating.
The thing is, though, I think why put that song on anyway? Because obviously, context of song's got different things in that they're not very friendly.
Yeah.
And I think it's just a bit weird.
Yeah, I thought.
I mean, it's a PG in it, end of day. It needs to be like, you need your parent with you to explain what's going on with song. I mean, there's such a lot of good music out there, and this is what I mean. Some music is brilliant, and it'd be nice to know if they did things that had come from some movies and what have you. If they did like a movie showcase. Yeah, Grease has got some great songs in it.
Yeah.
You know, but lots of songs are just great.
Yeah. I know Grease has its own. Just Dance
lookalike. Yeah. Britney Spears. That's one of Jack's favourites. Oh, yeah. It's an old Britney Spears dance. Guilty games.
Pleasure.
I think I saw that video.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
Grease.
Yeah, I've loved
it. He loved every minute.
That was the moment. That was the moment of truth right there. Where my R at?
And she's so sweet, Britney Spears and all. It's like,
yeah.
But yeah, that were fun day. Jack's done loads of them sort of videos with dance and stuff, haven't you? Dance Smurf stuff.
I saw the Smurf party one.
God, that was brilliant. That was so funny. We were laughing his heads off at that one. It was such a funny game.
Like that was pretty much in so bad it's good territory.
It was.
I know that I saw that for Trash Game Thursday.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah, there's a lot of... Yeah, we've played a lot of trash games, haven't we, Jack? Oh, Jack hasn't, I've just watched. Commented
I'm the guinea pig.
Yeah. We just love going down to CX and buying cheapest games we can. Ones that we've never heard of, or that just sound a right pile of tribe.
Yeah.
And then picking them up for like 25p, 50p a quid.
You're better off going for ones that are under 10 quid.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. I don't know if they still do this anymore, but you could pretty much get like PS2, like a terrible PS2 game for like 50p.
Yeah, it was great. We've had a couple of games though that were really cheap and have been massively surprising. That VR game you got that day, Jack, do you remember that? Is it that Stringer or something? That Western one?
Gunstringer, that on rails connects shooter.
It were absolutely brilliant, and it weren't even that expensive. And we got it because we thought it'd be rubbish, but actually it were brilliant. It was such a good game. So yeah, we've had a couple of good ones. Sound effects are funny in some games, some cheap games. It's like when a man's walking around, it sounds like he's got high heels on, like lady's shoes on, and you're like thinking, you've got big boots on, I can see them, but they don't sound like big boots when you're walking around.
In a way, our days of collecting Xbox 360 games kind of paid off.
Yeah, it did. Yeah, we've got a lot of games.
It would be nice as well to see a Judas Priest guitar.
Yeah. Breaking the law. Painkiller. Breaking the Law is my favourite video by Judas Priest. I absolutely love that video.
Yeah.
It's played on MTV all the time. It used to be so funny. This one laughs at it all the time. So, yeah.
Honestly, I wasn't expecting to wake up like this. I was too excited to come, and then
yeah,
I woke up at like 7 o'clock. It was like,
well, you needed a cape. That's alright. It's fine. It's good that you're so comfortable. You just chilled out and went to sleep for a bit.
Yeah.
I came in gaming room to set up, and Jack were in here already. Lewis was just absolutely flat out on
he was just shattered.
And I said, oh, you're all right, Lewis.
I don't know if you saw Jack.
He never even answered as well. He was like, I should have got a photograph here. But never even answered as we were like. But he weren't snoring, which is, it would have been even funnier if you were snoring, but you weren't.
I don't snore, luckily.
But yeah, we were just like, and we tried to wake you up, but you didn't wake up, so we just left you. And then I was thinking, oh, maybe I should check for first aid purposes that you're all right. But you seem to be
I'm
okay,
fine.
You were nice and content.
I like to think I don't snore, but let's be real, I probably do.
I really snore bad.
And when I'm really tired, I do snore. I wake myself up. It's like, my husband's like, what?
I'm still breathing.
Exactly, still breathing. As long as you're still breathing, still air in your lungs, sun in the sky, we're sorted.
Normally you think it comes from your nose.
Yeah. It comes from back of your throat, I think. You know, like between the area between your nose and your mouth, back of your mouth. That is, I think that's where snoring happens, that bit there. So,
what I'm going to do after this is I'm going to help finish edit uploading to YouTube.
Yeah, so Lewis did some recording this morning, so we're going to like finish that editing off, aren't we, after we finish
before
recording here
comes.
Yeah, be good.
I don't know, she'll come straight through the building or something.
Well, straight through, just like I'm going straight through the building. Yeah. You just doo, I mean, yeah. Big holes in wall from where you just come through. I turn into the
she'll come
on the way
bursting in like the Kool-Aid man.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Or like the Fonz. Yeah.
Or Duff Man.
Yeah. Duff Man. Oh yeah.
Oh, why did I even think of that?
Bit of Duff beer, because it's Duff.
Oh,
he's got green hair, I've just noticed.
I think that's part of his Fortnite skin.
Are these pictures in the background, are they Snoop Dogg's pictures? Are they things he's drawn?
I don't think they would have gone that far during the collab, would you?
I just like the little llama type thing up there. That looks quite cool.
I think because it's a new season, actually I don't know.
I hope they do a Christmas one. I hope they've got lots of Christmas songs on.
We're getting that one Mariah Carey song in November. Calling it now.
Really? Cool.
Nothing's been confirmed, I'm just saying.
It better happen. If it's on Clone Hero, then it should be on here.
To you, Mariah.
Mariah's just brilliant. We just know she'll be. There will be defrosting her, and
that one song that not a single retail worker seems to like.
I know what's wrong with him. It's one of the best songs ever. It's such a good song.
It's great. It just triggers PTSD for them.
Yeah, but why? There's other song. I would rather listen to Mariah Carey once an hour, once every 30 minutes if I had to, than listen to some other tribe they put on. I mean, for goodness sake. There's some really good Crimbo songs. We've had this conversation before, haven't we, Jack, when we talk about Christmas songs on Clone Era. The Darkness is such a good song.
Don't let the bells end.
Yeah.
Christmas!
Yeah, you've got to get really high. Justin's got such an high voice, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I don't know how people do it, and frankly, I don't want to know.
I don't think I even want to know anyway.
I think it's called a falsetto when somebody can sing that high, because Matt Bellamy can do it as well. He can sing really high, but he can go really low as well. So some can just do the whole range, which is amazing. So can you imagine being able to sing really high and really low and still singing tune?
I can't imagine that.
Yeah. Well, apparently when Matt Bellamy first started singing, he wouldn't sing properly. He was that scared of his voice frightening people because he could do these really high notes that he wouldn't do it. And then one day, as somebody said, you sound brilliant, but I think you could sound better, just let it go. And then he did.
I remember one part of a show that I watched. I think it was The Masked Singer.
Yeah.
And there was this guy, girl, whatever it was, it was in a robot costume.
Oh yeah.
And like a robot chicken costume.
Yeah. And, like you do. That's what you need, Jack, a robot chicken costume.
So. And it went from high and low.
Yeah.
And I couldn't tell who it was at the time.
Was that Justin? Or it just an utter darkness? Because you were on there, weren't you?
I don't know, actually.
Have you done then, Jack? Is that your two-penny for the day?
Yeah, that is Fortnite Festival with the PDP Riffmaster.
Yeah, so I think that's pretty cool. I mean, I've really enjoyed seeing that guitar at work. It's good. I like it. Thanks for bringing it in and showing us. I'm sort of chuffed to bits. So, yeah, it's been good. Fortnite's a really cool game. So, yeah, this were a thumbs up Thursday, by the way, guys. It wasn't a trash one because we would never trash a rhythm game because we love them.
I'm pretty much a rhythm game nut.
Yeah, I mean, even the one on the Wii, that kids one, we hadn't even trashed that one, I don't think. I don't know whether we did. No, we didn't. We thought it were okay, but it's okay for kids.
It was more of an irony thing.
Yeah. But yeah, it's been good. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So yeah, so there you go. You saw a bit of Snoop Dogg dancing without his wee invisible instruments and an orchestra. Yeah. Pretty enjoyable. Yeah. Nice one. Right, well, I'm sure Jack will bring it in again, I hope. So probably for Christmas versions. Oh, so they have Christmas songs.
Clone Heroes.
If they decide to add like Christmas songs like mid-season or something like that.
Oh, it'd be cool, wouldn't it? It'd be nice. Yeah. Right, well, thanks for watching. And give us a like and a subscribe if you want to, if you've enjoyed it. If you want Jack to play a game that you think is absolutely thumbs up or absolutely trash, let us know and we'll see if we've either got it in our library or we'll go and try and get it. So don't obviously tell us about a game that's worth about £3 million that we can't afford to buy, because I'm not kidding. Somebody will put, oh, there's this game on here. It's brilliant, this one. This is what you need to play. And then we'll look at price and be like, no, I don't think so. We can't afford that one. Yeah. We like to get our games at a bargain price.
And I mainly say this as a Tale Concerto fan. I may love Waffle, but for $500, I don't think I love him that much.
And with that, we're going. We've done. We've done with it. Enjoy the rest of your day, guys. Thanks for watching. Take care.